हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू MJC लर्निंग। टुडे वी विल लर्न द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज यूटिलिटी एनालिसिस। दिस चैप्टर बेसिकली डील्स विथ फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन। इन इंट्रोडक्शन वी विल लर्न द मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। सेकंड वन, व्हाट आर द वेरियस फीचर्स ऑफ यूटिलिटी। Third, what are the various types of utility? And the fourth one, various concepts of utility. Fifth one, law of diminishing marginal utility. Dear students, now let us start with the introduction part. See, dear students, the concept of utility is not new to you. We have already learned about the utility in standard 11, but now in standard 12 we will have in-depth knowledge about the utility. But before we start with the chapter, we should have a knowledge about the utility. So for the first time, students, Dr. Alfred Marshall explained utility analysis in his book called Principle of Economics, which was published in the year 1890. So let us first have a look on the meaning and definition of economics. When we come to meaning can be broadly classified into two parts. First is the general meaning. Second one, what do we mean by utility in economics? So let us come to the general meaning of utility. Generally, utility means usefulness of a community. For example, you have passed standard 11th. So the books of standard 11th is no more useful to you. So it does not possess any utility to you. Now you have come to standard 12. So the standard 12 books are more useful to you. So the standard 12 book possesses the more utility to you as compared to the book of standard 11th. But in economics, utility means the want satisfying power of a community. Now this meaning can be better understood when we look to the definition of economics given by Stanley Jevons. According to Stanley Jevons, utility is the capacity of a community to satisfy human wants. This definition can be understood with an example. For example, rotten egg, expired medicine cannot satisfy any human want. So no one will buy it and demand it. So it does not possess any utility. So let us first have a look . I hope the meaning and the definition of utility is clear to you. Now let us proceed with the features of utility. Feature is also known as characteristics. Whenever in the examination it comes that write the features of utility, or it may be asked to write the characteristics of utility. Both the features and the characteristics of utility are both one and the same. There are 10 features of utility. Now let us start with the first feature of utility. So the first feature of utility is a relative concept. Here the term relative does not mean the guest, but it means that utility is related to time and place. That is, it changes with time and place. According to time. Now let us see the features of utility with related to time. So according to time, the cotton clothes have more utility in summer and the woolen clothes have more utility in winter, whereas the rainy coats have more utility during the rainy seasons than in the summer season. Similarly, the cold drinks have more utility during the summer season as compared to the winter season. So all these three examples given by me
regarding the cotton clothes, raincoats and the cool drinks are all three related to the time. Now let us see the feature with the according to place. We can say that the woolen clothes have more utility in Kashmir than in Mumbai. First example. Second one, Ratnagiri Alfonso mango and the Nagpur oranges have more utility in Mumbai. Third one, the books have more utility in library than in the bookshop. So with the help of this example, we can better understood the first feature of utility, that utility is relative concept, that it is related to time and place. Dear students, I hope that the first feature of utility, that is utility is a relative concept, is clear to you. Now let us proceed with the second feature. The second feature of utility is that the utility is a subjective concept. Subjective concept, that is it is a psychological concept. Psychological concept means that is it exists in the mind of the consumer. Any goods or commodity does not possess the same utility. Whatever the goods you take, every goods does not have the same utility to all the individuals. It differs from person to person due to the difference in taste, preference, choice, liking, etc. of the people. For example, these features can be better understood with the help of the example. For example, when we take an example of a book have a greater utility to an educated person than an illiterate person. Similarly, a chalk have a more utility to a teacher than a student. So I hope the second feature, that the utility is a subjective concept, it differs from person to person. Got it? Is this clear? Now let us proceed to the third feature. The third feature is that the utility is ethically neutral concept. What is the third feature? Utility is a ethically neutral concept. A commodity which possesses utility may satisfy any want. Are you getting? Any commodity which has an utility may satisfy any want. It does not make any difference between the good, bad, moral, immoral, etc. These features can also be better understood with the help of example. For example, when we take a knife has a utility for a housewife to cut the vegetable. In the same way, it has an utility to a killer to harm someone. Are you getting this? A knife which is used by the housewife to cut the vegetable, it is giving the utility to the housewife for cutting the vegetable. Same knife can be used by the killer to harm somebody. Let us look to the second example. A gun which has a utility for a soldier, as well as it has the utility to the terrorist also. In the both the cases, we see that the knife and the gun does not make any difference between the good, bad, moral and immoral. Hence, we say that the utility is ethically a neutral concept.